Across the Yunan Bridge is the central island of Taoranting Park. Standing on the bridge, we can see Taoran Pavilion not far away. The earliest building in Taoranting Park is the Cibei Nunnery in front of us. It built in the Yuan Dynasty was named the Guanyin Temple. The monastery was rebuilt twice in the Qing Dynasty. Because of the beautiful scenery, the park could attract scholars and celebrities together. After the May 4th movement, many revolutionaries came here to discuss major issues. They took a group photo in front of the Cibei Nunnery, right in front of the Lucas tree. Under the tree is their photos at that time. In the photo, we can see Mao Zedong and other members. If you step on the threshold, you are disrespectful to the owner. The plaque above is said to be new. On the north side of front yard is the Guanyin Hall, which is the main hall. In the middle of the hall is the Guanyin Bodhisattva. The two sides are Wenshu and Puxian Bodhisattva. In ancient times, it was worshipped by Amitabha, Da Shi Zhi, and Guanyin Bodhisattva. The plaque we see is Zizai Ke Guan, which used to be Da Zizai in the Qing Dynasty. The stone tablet in front of us is a memorial to the rebuilding of Cibei Nunnery in 1897. The word Chui Sheng Wang Ji in the cloud pattern on the tablet means that the reputation has been passed on for a long time. Guanyin Bodhisattva Prajna Paramita in the 25th year of Republic of China. It's quite a little country yard had a lot to offer. This Rivaja is from the Liao Dynasty and had been around for nearly 1,000 years. It was built to commemorate the monk Cizhi, and his life was engraved and buried. The Rivaja records that he was buried in the eastern suburb of Yanjing. It is a cultural relic that determines the exact location of Nanjing City in the Liao Dynasty and Jinzhongdu. Behind the Rivaja is the famous Wenchang Pavilion. The plaque on the door is Yinzai Erdu. It means to use different education methods according to different students. Inside the gate is the Zitong Dijun, also known as Wenchang Wang, God who protects the cultural movement and exams. In the north hall of Cibei Nunnery, we can see a picture of Liu Hai placed with a golden toad. The furnishings in 1920 was restored here when Zhou Enlai, Li Dazhao, and other group representatives were meeting. This is the memorial hall of Gao Junyu and Shi Pingmei. They passed with their lives for the early revolutionary cause. In the final room, we can see pictures of the early communists and the way forward for Chinese Communist Party to save the Chinese nation. Next, we came to Taoran Pavilion. Taoranting Park was named after it. This monument was erected in 1930. In 1695, in the Qing Dynasty, a small pavilion was built by Jiang Zhao, and the plaque was inscribed with Taoran, formerly known as Jiangting. The pavilion was soon expanded to 3 open rooms. Taoran Pavilion is one of the 4 famous pavilions in China because of its beautiful environment. Several stone carvings are embedded in the south wall. black ones is Taoran in primer with the postscript and Taoran Tingji. Below the white is Tan Sitong's old inscription from the south of city, and invite Tong Zhujun to compile and revise the collection of Taoranting. The original author of this couplet is Lin Dexu. The north wall is embedded with four pictures of daffodils by Peng Babai. The veranda outside Taoran Pavilion is not an ancient building. It connects Taoran Pavilion and Cibei Nunnery from the outside.
这应该是老东西，甭管这个庵有没有重新修，没菊，哎，差一个，不是梅兰竹菊吗？是不是在别的方向？哎，不是，它是两边都是竹，中间是个梅，
就葫芦的，
它是挺水下去，然后从那边那个整个就我刚才看那个地方。
应该是那个。
After leaving the Cibei Nunnery, the Westcom Lake is now full of cruise trips. I also saw some internet celebrities come to the park to film. Taoranting is one of the four famous pavilions in China. The park also imitates pavilions from all over China. We can visit the beauty of Chinese pavilion in single day because it. Please look forward to our next video. If you like us, subscribe and like, please. Thank you.